Hello everybody, how's it going? My name is Klaus, this is my house, and today we're back here with some more County Crossing. Now you can see I've gone ahead and I've run my cable all over the place, so we're ready for the hookups. And I think I had mentioned putting the power in here, so let us go ahead and do that. Now we have some special stuff because of awesomeness. Man, I was recalling these to be a little bit smaller. Not gonna lie, I recall these being quite small. So these. Oh, I can't even move it out. All right, these are the new Vault-Tec things. Now the reactor is all cool, but this is the super reactors. That's really what I want. Now. Forget how we did it. I mean, we could scale it. We could do that. Because this certainly will not do. I feel like if they would have just let me do some stuff, we would have been okay. Let's go ahead and scale it. Why not? Let's go ahead and do that. And it's a little bit cheap, but whatever. We can do whatever we want to do. Right? And then let's disable it one more time and enable it one more time. Yep, and that worked last time. Okay, cool. So now we have super tiny crazy reactor. No, let's not do any of that. All right, and yeah, we should pretty much be good. So let's go ahead and start getting our stuff going here. We need that, and then one from the ceiling is probably the best way to go about that. All right, so we connect those, and there we go, and boom. Now all the stuff should light up because we have done this all the way around. So even the stuff over here, that stuff over there doesn't look like it's getting lit. Is that on? No, it's not. That's odd. Right? And it says you're not getting any. That's weird. You're getting them here, but you're not getting them there. Wait. But that's... What? That's weird. Oh, now it's not getting it there. Oh, wow. Okay, we've got weird things happening. See, why isn't... Right? Okay. Right. Requires power. Doesn't require power. Requires power. So, that's kind of weird. So, wait, is this one not there either? That is. So, this one lights up, but this one doesn't. Oh, wow. I've done some crazy things, apparently. Don't quite know what to think. And what's with these? Right, now it's on. Huh. Well, that's awkward, isn't it? I guess I can run some more power and try and resolve this. I honestly don't know. It looks kind of like things are going and working out, except for this stuff over here still. This doesn't totally seem to be, like, worth the effort at the moment. It will eventually be worth the effort, but like I said, not right now. So what we want to do is work on some of our defenses. I had mentioned using a guard post here before, and I think that's probably the best thing to do. It just kind of looks like it fits. So we're going to have to go over to our barn stuff and get our supports, because we need to make things look sort of like they belong. When I say sort of, doesn't need to be realistic looking in any way, eh? All right, and that's that one. We kind of just want it to do something like that. That might even be a little bit high. You can always push this one up. That's probably decent. All right, so that's going to be that. And I suppose it does kind of get in the way here, but at least it doesn't look like it's hanging off, so that's kind of lame. More or less, we're a little bit open from the front. So what we want to do is, in addition to this guard post here, we want to get some turrets that are going to go up on these roofs here. They're going to be our first line of defense. Since we do only have one entrance to the settlement, it is more or less important that we kind of have a good grasp on what's going on there. So I'm going to put some heavy laser turrets. And we can kind of have these facing all sorts of directions. But this should give you guys at least a feel for kind of what we're going for here. And yeah, definitely something like that. So it's going to be a good idea to leave some pointing inwards, because yeah, it is somewhat of an open gate. If people do end up getting through, then we'll be able to cover them once they get into the inside. Now, that kind of goes for this as well. And I'm not seeing this as a justification at all. There's just not a whole lot of room there for something like that. This, on the other hand, is another good one to look on the inside. And it doesn't look like it's being wasted at all, really. All right, and we can go over to this one over here, and we'll go up our little stairs. And let's go flying a little bit. Wait, are these ones on? No. Oh, they're not. All right. So again, we have some outer ones that are going to protect us from what lay beyond. And yeah, definitely even one that's gonna go there. All right, and let's hope that we can actually jump. Oh, so close, yet so far away. All right, and this is actually a perfect place for him here, because we're gonna get ourselves some wonderful defense, and I might as well put it in the middle there, kinda. Interesting. All right, and this is also a decent one to look off that way. We have a good amount of them that are going to be facing inwards. All right, here we go. Oh, oof, almost lost it. All right, this is actually another really good location. We did a good job, kind of unknowingly, at having buildings that really can defend just about anywhere. And we should probably have some on our inner workings as well, just because that's going to be kind of important. Only kind of. Alright, and we'll toss another one right there for shits and giggles. Alright, that looks pretty decent. Oh, darn. Thought I was going to make that. Jumped a little bit too late. And more or less, the strategy is going to be very, very similar all throughout here. I don't think we're going to need too many that actually reside pointing inwards. But it's definitely going to be helpful to have these ones here that are going to look at our boundaries. Which is more or less what we meant by doing this area over here. In fact, we can kind of angle that one so it can see out. And arguably, we probably don't need a whole lot. I mean, we're doing pretty good on defense as it is. And we will have some human backup to this, so just in case this stuff goes down, we won't be SOL or anything like that. Now, it is kind of unfortunate. Oh, come on. And let's get this one on both of them, actually. Oh, come on. There we go. We just want to jump around and have a good time. Can't we do that? Oh, we're able to poop through. Nope. Come on. There we go. All right. So that gets us on the inside there. Well, might as well go up here. So just since we're over here. And this is probably going to be one of the areas that we're least ready to defend. And that's pretty much just this general direction here. Turret-wise, we don't really have a whole lot. I don't think we're going to need a whole lot. This is the furthest side from the entrance, so if someone attacks here anyway, I'm not really worried about it, because they're either going to have to run around that side where we have a lot of turrets, or this side, which we're going to put some turrets there, and maybe even on that corner right there. So we should be good, more or less, in our defense of this area as well. And we'll place one here, just in case they do get inside. And this can kind of cover our path areas. All right, so for this area, again, we want to kind of back ourselves up and be cognizant of things that could be attacking our settlement. Now, I'm going to put some here anyway. Even though you can't get in, I'm sure there's going to be some group of numbnuts that get stuck right in there. And, yeah. That could be painful to deal with. More or less, I think we're pretty much wrapped up on the turrets. What we can do is just have like another two, maybe. I mean, that seems like pretty decent in terms of defense. Like, I don't think we're gonna need a whole lot more than that. Anyways, what I'm gonna go ahead and do now off camera is go hook these bad boys up. And then we'll be back and more or less just start decorating, putting in furniture, that kind of thing. We'll probably hit the bigger, more interesting houses first, leave the smaller ones for whenever. Or I could just completely forget about this by the time that we come back. But pretty much we'll get a little bit of furnishing in. If it ends up taking too long, then I'll just come back at the end of it. And we can talk about this settlement. So anyways, I will see you guys in a little bit. All right, guys, so I like wired a whole bunch of stuff up. I'm like, what the hell's the problem? You know, like, these ones are getting it. What the hell? Why is that one not getting it? And then I kind of like, I kind of just noticed that this is in a radius. But before I noticed that, I noticed that I never actually hooked these ones up, because they don't actually hook up like that. So there we go. More or less, things are pretty much alive. Not all of them. Not all of them. But a good portion of them. Now the question is, why are things like this not alive now? Those are all good. Why is this? Why is that not? Why is that not there? Huh? We got that coming across. We got that there. That goes up. That goes up. Ah! That would be a reason why. All right, boom. All right, so we have all of our stuff, and that's all fine and dandy. We're pretty much good and golden. Now, I mentioned that we were going to go try and do interesting things first, and I would like to do that. The one thing that I think we definitely need to get going here really quickly, though, is our beacon. Our beacon is kind of just kind of where it's at in terms of a lot of things, and we can kind of show it in corners like that, so we can still access this, but it's not really getting in the way of anything at all. All right, so let's go ahead and just kind of start with this, because I think this could be kind of an interesting little area. I don't exactly know what we're going to end up putting in a lot of this stuff. I'm going to be really, really honest with you. This is going to... wood. This is going to be kind of off the cuff. We're going to look at some of the vanilla extensions stuff. We got beds, furnitures, couches, all sorts of containers and whatnot. So it'll be kind of nice. We can probably get like a desk or something like that. Maybe this can be kind of like head of operations, as it were. You know, come up to the thing and operate. Yeah. Oh, yeah. All right. We should probably get this slide up a little bit better. Go right there. So this way someone can come up and do their stuff. Do their stuff right there. And then we can go ahead and get that again. It's kind of nice how the furniture actually snaps to each other or itself, depending, I suppose, on how you look at it. Probably, you know what, if we do this and then we keep kind of working our way down to this way, I think that's actually really, really nice. And then what this does is gives us the opportunity to have like very nice, well snapped stuff. Oh, interesting. So there's, Backer chair allows snapping furniture. Okay, so this seems to just be stuff that's going to allow you to work a little bit easier. So that's all well and good. We are going to need chairs in here, but it's probably good to keep looking at the other one. I don't know. Do we just give them regular chairs? I think these ones would be kind of cool. I also like how they snap like the perfect distance away, like dead on. That's pretty neat as well. Okay, let's go ahead and just say like we have a thing. Does it snap? Oh, it snaps on top of each other too. That's that. Wow. You know, you live and then you learn. That's the way the cookie crumbles. Oh, look at that. All right, so we can't do that, but if we took it and marched it on down like that, I'm trying to think of what would be better. If we did something like that, maybe? Oop, and we need to flip that to get it our way. All right, perfect. Kind of like a nice little, nice little thing. Is that viable, though? I think that's the real question here. That would kind of be nicer, wouldn't it? Fudge nuggets. That's a bit big, though. Yeah. This is arguably where it's at. Alright, let's go ahead and do that. Yeah, I can dig it. Alright. And, I don't know, we would just have, like, general things on there. Again, this is kind of like a little work center. So it's probably not a bad idea to get something like, scavenging thingy-mabobs over here as well. Just to kind of give it that worky feel. There we go. Alright, so they can put their shit there, they can go talk to these more administrative types and get their money. Because that's all that these people are after these days. Nothing but the damn caps. That's what it's all about. Alright, let's go put some Mr. House of Klaus artwork up. Because that's going to be important. In fact, we can even put them up above here, just to remind people whose thing is what. Alright, so we're all good in there. This is just going to be kind of like a little bedroom area. I didn't see too much in the way of containers over in the other thing that was... Oh. Ooh. Yeah, when you uninstall your mods, you kind of realize how much you had. And boy, did we have quite a bit. I don't remember a lot of this stuff. I just think that mod must have done something to really fuck that up. Because this seems like this is vault stuff. So this is new. Pommel horse, really? Weight bench? I mean, it's pretty sleek, but geez, we don't need that stuff right now. We just need some general containers. Now we got ourselves a half wall that looks like perfectly ready. Did look perfectly ready. Let's mod the position down by 40, because I think it's the stairs that are fucking with it. Behind it, right there. Alright, so that's all good. We got that. More or less, it is just kind of like a bedroom. So we don't need to, like, worry about too much. But would be nice to have... Yeah, some sort of end table. Just as like a thing. So these people, I think we could get lucky. Where's our military cots? Military cots. There we go. There we go. Maybe what we do is we do that one. Right? And if this gives us the ability to... Oh yeah, it does. Wow. Cool. Place a table, and I'm all happy. Alright, so we have little bedside tables so people can put their stuff on them. Now, I saw some very, very interesting things. And, whoops, I would want to put those in here. What this could be some sort of... it wasn't tables that we got them in, right? It was decorations, I think. Or miscellaneous? Yeah, miscellaneous seems right. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Let's give these guys a workout area. Because they seem like they might need it. Alright, and we can angle them so that they go right there. And then that probably gives me another bit of room to go ahead and dump one right there. Alright. So you got a little workout room type deal going on. You get a little counter, little countertop space. Nice counter on top of that. This ain't no cheap counter. And what else do we have here? We don't need the projector. Pommel horse produces happiness. The TV? No, but it does require... Okay. A dispenser, another dispenser. A water fountain. Okay, so if they're gonna be working out, we pretty much know that they're gonna need to be drinking that water. Kind of weird how it only wants to go up so high on a wall. It almost seems not counterproductive necessarily, but unfortunate. Alright. And yeah, it seems to be like a pretty decent workout room. Now, I can imagine that you're not always going to want to be working out. You know, it only makes sense. So we can go ahead and put some benches here. And these could be the wrong way. I could never figure out which way the benches were actually supposed to go. So, yeah, unfortunately for just the regular old people, that's kind of what they're going to get. Alright, and as we go out over here, we don't need a whole lot, but we could have a couple people that would, I don't know, sit at the door and just make sure that you're actually big enough to lift the weights that are in that room. Other than that, pretty decent spot. We also have a guard post right there, so that's pretty good. No one can come in and just easily take our weights, because that would be wrong. It would be wrong, and it would be mean. And we wouldn't like that very much. Oh, you know what? Since we're in here, we might as well do it. I know that I said we were going to do other stuff first. I mean, we're like at an hour on my recording right now, so who knows what we're going to end up getting. But yeah. We'll see. There we go. And this should be enough room, I hope, for to get two people that are just generally interested in looking out at things, to look out at them together. This is a home, and we haven't used a bureau in a while. I hope that it's not like a bureau, right? A bureau? Whatever. It doesn't quite matter. Alright. Yep. And that looks good there. I like the idea of the nightstand or end table. So we'll go ahead and we'll drop one of those. It's going to be kind of a mix of old and new. Our settlements are now going to benefit from everything that was left over from our wonderful stuff at Vault 88. So I'm trying to think here. Might even be a good idea almost to pull this out. I'm just thinking here, because I always like to have kind of a picnic-y type spot, a place where people can go hang out outdoors, where, you know, the sun is shining and stuff. Yeah. So always important to just get there we go. Something in there for the people that need it. So they can get some of that vitamin D or whatever the hell it is you get from the sun. Vitamin D or vitamin K? One of them becomes, I think it's D becomes K in the sun. I you know what? I don't know these things. Let's go ahead and pop in some stores, because those are always good. We'll get like a regular old trader deal kind of going on here. All right, so we got a trader. And food and drink wouldn't be bad. We can also make that a number two. And then a clinic. Clinics are always nice as well to have. So we can dump that right over there. All right, and stuff like this is just kind of really nice. You know, in thinking about it. We can have this come up to here. It'll give plenty of room for people to kind of come in and do their thing. Now, I think it's probably important that we make it so that these aren't not blue like they would be. Just because I think that also entails of whether or not people can actually come up from behind. So as long as it's regular old blue, I am regular old happy. So we got some regular old bed stuff. We got a regular old lot of things. That kind of doesn't suffice, I guess, for like that picnic area. But we might be able to throw in a thing or two here. If we have some decent tables. Like these ones kind of aren't bad. And then I think we have food and drink, right? Yeah, we have a bar. So basically we can just kind of say, oh yeah, yeah, that's what those are for. Right there. Yeah. And this ain't no fancy place. We're just gonna go ahead and toss our stuff like that. All about. And we have like a little shopping area, a little outdoor dining area. Or just, you know, to sit down if you need a break. Let's go ahead and interesting and get ourselves like a magazine rack for these people. Maybe they keep their magazine rack over here. I could actually see that. So that's their magazine rack where they would obviously put their magazines, and you don't need a thing that big. I'm thinking is that we just have them over here like that, so that way what they can do, sit here in the shade, read their magazines, hear the of all of the protective equipment we have outside, and they should be happy, grateful, all of those things. All right, that looks pretty decent to me as well. So we've kind of hooked up this room a little bit. We still haven't done this one, and this one I kind of want to make like a social spot. Let's go ahead and whoa. Huh. I wonder what we could do with the desk additions. Oh, and those are nice counters, actually. Those are very nice counters. But that's not what I'm here for. Don't get distracted, Klaus. Don't get distracted. This is what we came for. Alrighty. So we've got ourselves a nice little pool table. And we should probably just have this be like a little lounging spot. Nothing too crazy. Just things. People. Places. Alright. Now, if we build like a really, really small settlement, I could see us maybe going a little bit more in depth with some of this stuff. But for this, I don't really see the need. Kind of get some just general happiness going on in here. Now, I did see that we have our overseer's desk. I don't think that's necessarily a thing that I want to put in the settlement. Maybe in the next one in Somerville Place, if we can actually get ourselves all sorts of hooked up over there, I could be pretty down with that. All right, everybody, we're back over here in the settlement. We got things all sorts of ready for you to see. So this is just kind of our view from the entrance. It's a nice, decently foggy day. But if you can make it past the gate like this doctor has, you can head on over to here for a quick nap and kind of a more transient style house. Nothing to really hold you down. We have a nice little suite up here. We got the kitchen, kind of a little dining area, our bed, obviously some TV. This person's going to be having some fun. We got our guard post set up, I think, in a pretty decent direction to actually just be able to keep an eye on things, kind of supplement all the turrets that we have. It's always nice to actually have a couple human defenders in my just kind of mind. And then we have just a regular old kind of hangout area. This is going to be full of seating and stuff. Kind of have the idea of there would be like books and stuff here, and this is just for people that are going to be relaxing. There's a lot of space, so we kind of had to get creative. Most of it's going to be houses, though. Like up here, we have just a single home. Didn't really go too crazy on these ones up here, but we do. And what I will probably do is try and assign some beds there. But we do have these two guard posts that I'm hoping I can get the person that lives in there and the person that lives in there assigned to this guard post and that guard post, respectively. Coming down from there, we kind of have some options. What is kind of nice about this is that you somewhat have to already be in the settlement to get anywhere. So it's kind of a nice, what am I trying to say? It's like a nice middle point where there's still enough room to get in and there's a lot of places to walk around. But you can still really only get into it from one spot. So in here we kind of have our little barber shop. We got a sink so people can keep their hands clean and maybe do some shampooing in there. I don't know. We got two barber chairs. We got a little waiting area with a television. And this is a little rollaway cart. They can put all their barber crap on there. Coming in here, another sort of hangout area. I thought that these were actually just kind of really nice if you could imagine someone just sitting down in here and relaxing and you know, looking outside. Some storage as well. Got some lockers, so nothing too fancy. Nothing too fancy. Have another guard post just to make sure that we're all good here. And then we just kind of have, like, I'm going to call this a nap spot. It's not really a house. It's not really a room. It's definitely a little open for my liking for it to be a house. It's just kind of on the front lines, as it were. And with all this extra space, probably not the best spot. Going upstairs, though, we do have that little outdoor seating area that I had mentioned. Again, nothing too fancy. We're just kind of filling it in with relevant things, chairs, stuff like that, stuff that people are going to need. But the stuff that's going to make people happy is most definitely up in here. We have a nice little gym, as it were. Now, these weightlifting benches do generate happiness, so that's something. There's also a pommel horse. I didn't know what that was going to be like in terms of animations and stuff like that, so I didn't put it in here. I didn't know if these ceilings were high enough or anything like that. We do have a water fountain, so we can make sure our people are properly hydrated, and just a general dispenser, so, you know, maybe there's some other fancy drinks that they would like from there. Moving on, we are now out of our bounds. and then we basically have kind of what I'm going to call the twin homes. So there's one here, and then there is like the identical layout on the other side. Pretty much like we did over there. I thought these were really nice opportunities to kind of like look down on our farm. Lots of good views from these spots, but these are just kind of regular old houses as well. Now the twin layout is up over here. As you can see, this is a more private seating area. We got, you know, regular old cabinetry and whatnot. So this could be a single person living area. Over here, we kind of have another little hangout room, a pool table, lots of nice viewing. Kind of doubles up to keep an eye on the roads and all of that. Moving in here, we have a power room, which we did shrink this down. If you're somehow just joining us at this point, you don't know how the hell we did this. We just scaled it down a little bit so it fit in this room. And then we just kind of have two more beds over here. Now, I was thinking about getting some of the farmers assigned to that bed, but I don't know how well it's going to work out. Also, we have kind of an administrative section in here with our desks. The people will do their work. And we got some scavenging posts that we can probably assign some people to. And more or less, we've touched on a lot. We have our little shopping section, which we always have in our settlements, a little seating area to kind of facilitate that as well. Nothing really down this way except for our defense at the gate. And then last but not least, we have a doctor, or a surgeon, I should say. We kind of have our receptionist here, and I thought the overseer's desk was a very nice addition to this, and I just kind of clipped a terminal into it. I kind of wish there was better terminals, but at least where I was looking, this is just kind of what I had available. But then over here, you know, we're trying to keep people calm with our nice cat pictures. And yeah, this is our surgery station. So I don't know how much those are going to get used. They are part of the Vault Tech DLC, so I'll probably assign a person and just kind of like experiment with it. I believe the surgical stuff is just so that you can like literally change your character's appearance, which, I don't know, seems a little cheap. You know, when you make a character, you gotta commit, damn it. This is the real world. Yeah. Anyways, guys, this has pretty much been it for County Crossing. We're gonna be going over to Somerville Place next and taking a look more on the vaulty side of things. I'm gonna go check through all of my stuff and see if I have like some rocks or something like that so we can kind of like build a cave and then make a vault on the inside of that. So we're going to do that when we come back. So I hope you enjoyed this settlement. If you did, let me know down below in that comment section. Otherwise, have a great day, great night, whatever it is to you. And I will see you back here next time for some more building in Fallout 4.